Shabada Dagas Zama Taliba Zebas Zabadia Manadaga Zobos Kidamanadasa Nabadiba Dadaba Nagabadadinanda. Unchain her work, unchain her wealth, unchain her glory, unchain what you took away from this family, unchain it, unchain it, unchain it. Loosen the husband's job. Fungua kazi ya mume wake, fungua kazi ya mume wake, fungua kazi ya watoto, fungua watoto wake. Loosen the work. Liver. Clap your hands and give him praise. I need 7 brothers behind that man. From the father's side, the grandfather was a witch doctor. The mother's side, the grandmother, that side, they were also witch doctors. Tonight, those are 7 men. Bring that man here. Msimamisha hapo. Msimamisha hapo. We want to go into an operation. I go to the grandfather's side. I take authority from the shrine. I command 7 generations from the father's side. Whatever you wanted this man to become, I take him from your hands tonight. I go to the mother's side. I approach the shrine. Whatever you wanted him to become, I take him from your hands. The snake that you sent to accompany him in the journey of life, I take the sword of God and I kill the snake tonight. 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 Snake. Now one more time. One more time. I hold his hands. I travel with him the road he followed from school. I take the hands of the grandmother and I remove them from his life. I take him into the granary that he entered for initiation. I bring him out by the blood of Jesus. And I take the fire of the Holy Spirit and I throw it on this man's life. Take it. Put him on the floor. On the floor. Now listen to me. I'm not doing a pre-planned thing. I know this man. And until the teachings of the birthday, he has never opened up like he opened up to me. Those nose rings will have to go. I have his story. He told me his story. He has never opened up. This man was dying until he had me on radio many years ago. And if you are very keen and watch our videos, he's been delivered several times. But until he opened up today, that's why I took that journey. I want you to understand, we are playing no game here. You understand? So I had to pray, and the Lord told me, this is what you are going to do. The mother's side was a witch doctor. The father's side was a witch doctor. He was to carry the mantle of witchcraft. Coming from school, he met a snake that spoke to him. The snake is dead tonight. I kill that snake tonight. Father, I pray that this man will find mercy before you. I've known him for long. I've wrestled for his liberty. I pray that this one tonight will release wealth into his hands. We'll give him a wife. We'll give him a responsible family. The change will be evident. He traveled all the way from Mombasa. He's not going back empty-handed. He is free tonight. Bring communion. Bring bread and blood. Put the communion scripture there. A life matters. One life matters. What Paul received from the Lord Jesus, in the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take it, this is my body, which was broken for you." Jesus paid for this life. Give him the bread. Put it in his mouth. I need security guys around that area. Put it in his mouth. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Every covenant that was made with him, today Jesus takes control. The blood goes in and dissolves every covenant. Give him the blood. Give him the blood. Give him the blood. Give him the blood. That's the power of communion. He's free. He's free. Now, I beg you for only this Sunday. Tell your neighbor, only this Sunday. Because we will have communion and deliverance Sunday. And the Holy Spirit has asked me to ask you. I couldn't minister to all of you. I couldn't lay hands on some of you. I was not allowed by the Holy Spirit to do that. But I request some of you to sacrifice and attend Sunday service. It will be Deliverance Sunday, so that I will carry on with the work I've left now for Sunday. It's only this week I request you like that. I'm not trying to make you to join this church. No. But this is about your life. You can be here at 10. Najua naizaenda mpaka 3. From what I'm seeing that God is going to do, God will finish up some work that is left on Sunday. I request you, get your brother, get your sister. I don't know again when this will happen. So allow me finish my work. The Holy Spirit does this on Sunday. It will be amazing, I tell you. God will help us with miracles as well. Mungu ataponya watu,
you will see healings that only him can do. Me ni kama wewe tu. But him, the Holy Spirit, will do that. Can somebody say amen?